my lovelies. I'm back. I'm gonna be out of commission probably for a little bit. I'm gonna try to still do cards anyway. I just don't know if I'm going to be able to, so I decided to get on here and make sure that I give y'all some good words of advice before I go into surgery tomorrow. So I hope y'all lift me up in some prayers. It's gonna be good. I'm finally gonna take care of my tatas. So Thank you. I can feel all of y'all like, yeah, whoop, tap time. It is tap time. So anyway, let's see what we got right now. I've got my fountain tarot deck out, and that's what I'm shuffling right now. So I'm trying to get y'all's energy. I hope you've already tapped in. Not everything will resonate with you if it's a general reading. If you want a more specific reading, then you know how to reach me, folks. I really like to go ahead and just, you know, get a little bit of energy out here for the collective. We're going to run through the signs real quick and see if I can get everybody down. Start off with Capricorn. Capricorn's spirit, what do you have for our Capricorn viewers? Let's go ahead and see. It's already hot up in here. Oh, Capricorn, you've got some things you need to release. You've got some toxic energy around you, some bad habits that you might need to be kicking. I would look into how you can improve your health overall. You've been stuck in the same place for a while. I feel like Spirit wants you to do a little fast, maybe a cleanse, a detox, something that can help you make a sacrifice. Yeah, because you're stuck. You need something to change, and I feel like you're wanting some stability in your life. If you're wanting to hear from Spirit, I say tap in, do a cleanse, and make more effort to pray and meditate. You need to make more decisions that keep you away from feeling around people that make you feel very defensive. So if you have people that kind of trigger you to always feel like you're having to explain yourself or, you know, justify something that you're doing. Maybe you're not with your tribe, maybe you're not feeling welcome, or maybe you need to really rebalance all of your energies and see if there might be something that you're doing that's offsetting to other people, okay? We don't want to change ourselves completely, but we don't want to lose valuable relationships and friendships, okay? So right now I feel like there is going to be some victory for you. Not in relationships, but I feel like there is going to be some new opportunities that are going to come in love. But you're going to have to make the effort to stay out of denial about the place that you're in emotionally. I feel like you definitely are still in a tender spot, whether you realized it or not. You're still waiting on the scales of justice to be balanced out so you get your happily ever after is what I'm getting. Okay, Aries. Aries, I see you being drinking way too much. You're enjoying drinking way too much, but I feel like you're really trying to escape a problem that you have, or you're in denial about a situation that was leaving you heartbroken, maybe even regretful, remorseful. And I feel like you want your justice for the person that brought negativity in your life. I feel like someone disappointed you greatly, and it kind of changed your whole vibes on relationships in general. So next, Virgo. What do we got for Virgo? Virgo, whatever it is that you've been stressing about, you know exactly what it is as soon as I said this, whatever you thought of whenever I said that, you need to go ahead and let it go. It's the end of a cycle, and you've been carrying too many burdens for way too long. I feel like you've done a lot of work, you've done a lot of praying, you've done a lot of healing, you've done a lot of soul searching, and now is the time for you to get your reward. You are blocking new opportunities because you are still stuck in the energy of wanting some justice for a situation that happened to you in the past. Pisces, we're gonna go ahead and do you next. Oh, hold on, as soon as I flip all these cards, they're upside down. Okay, Pisces, what do we have for our Pisces collective? It looks like you're going within about a lot of stuff right now, Pisces. You have a lot of things on your mind. I feel like you've taken some actions that you might have regretted. The Ace of Wands is in reverse. So you might be wanting to make some changes regarding some of the actions that you've taken. Maybe you feel like it's not the best route, or yeah, you've lost some hope in a situation where you're dealing with someone who's very volatile. And you've been either keeping an eye on them because I feel like you lost your sunshine, and you're really trying to get yourself out of this energy of worrying about this situation. If you see here, you have the fountain in reverse, you have the Queen of Swords in reverse, the Page of Swords, which is our little spying card on the internet, the loss of hope, and the wanting to release the burdens and the mental anguish that you're under, the sleepless nights, the things that you have regrets about, the things that you've been going over and over in your head about. You're still holding on to some of it, so go ahead and let it loose, because you have great things coming for your future. You really need to stop drinking so much, because I feel like it's definitely, you're holding back communication on a situation that you have been sitting on for a while. You've been thinking about some things for a while, and I feel like the universe is saying it's time to go ahead and take action on them, but you do need to keep a clear head. You're not really thinking clearly. You're trying to delude yourself a little bit, because things are changing in your world right now, and I feel like you're not comfortable with change, even though you want change. So let's see. Okay, let's go ahead and go on to, who are we doing next, Taurus? Okay, the Knight of Cups. I feel like there's a little bit of love lost here. You had a situation that you thought was gonna bloom, and it's kind of been a back and forth, wishy-washy energy. And I feel like you think it's very childish and you're tired of playing with it. It's definitely feeling like it's an issue that gives you a lot of feelings of unworthiness and self-doubt. And really, you shouldn't have any of that. You're actually really stable on your own. And you do have love coming to you, Taurus. And this person will be very secure in what they want with you. And they are going to be very romantic and passionate. And they will not be keeping any secrets from you. It'll be someone that you can communicate with very openly, honestly. And it's going to be beautiful. A beautiful union. So, Taurus, I'm done talking to you. Get out of your head. And just know the good things are coming for you. Because, baby, you deserve it, love. Okay, Gemini. What do we have for Gemini? Okay, the Eight of Cups is walking away from an emotional situation, and it feels that you are stuck in stagnant energy. It feels like you have definitely done, your fair share of being remorseful about the situation, but you're done with that. You're walking into your power now. I feel like going into, we're in Taurus season right now, but we'll be heading into Gemini season pretty soon, and things will be switched up for you, because you do have something coming up. Someone from the past that you have good memories with is going to be coming back into your life, I feel like, in Gemini season. So, very good, Taurus. Six of Wands. You're going to have victory, love. You're going to have a spotlight on you. Oh, I'm sorry. Wait, this was a Gemini reading. Oh, this is Gemini. Okay, I like all of this. There's an eight, there's a six, five, eight. There's three eights. Oh, no, that's two eights. Anyway, something very stable is coming for you, Gemini. Four of Wands is definitely a very stable situation. It can be sometimes a marriage, sometimes a union of some sort. And I feel like you may have a beach wedding. So finish resting up, Gemini, because you have someone coming for you. And this person is going to be amazing. It's going to be exactly what you were needing and wanting. This is wish fulfillment. I mean, the Star card is a high card. It's saying that everything that you could ever want is about to come to you. So congratulations, Gemini. What do we have for Cancer, what do we got here? Holy freak, give me some energy for Cancer. Cancer, I feel like you have been sleeping a lot. You've been resting a lot, and Spirit is asking you to come out of that. You need to get out of that resting energy. It's time to put in some work. What does Cancer need to do? What kind of work do they need to put in? The Judgment card came out in reverse. I feel like you feel like there's some type of debt that needs to be paid. And you've been given some divine intervention, but I feel like you're not hearing these steps clearly. So, Cancer, you're going to need to spend some time with a little bit of meditation, or even, finding some things to relax to keep your mind distracted from negativity. Right now, there's a situation in your life that is ending. There's a cycle that's going to be ending, a period of your life that's going to be changing drastically. And I feel like it's going to be putting you into a new energy of wanting to step it up with your finances. I feel like you're being divinely guided to head towards your passion. So, congratulations, Cancer. That sounds amazing. All right. So, this is y'all's check-in for the weekend. Y'all are moving into some new things. All right, Scorpio, we've got Two of Wands here. Two of Wands. So, you have some decisions to make and some actions that you need to take. You have two paths that you could take, and this could be job or romance. Scorpio, yeah, you're not sure which way this is supposed to go. I feel like there is a place that you have been that you feel like you should have elevated from already. And right now, Spirit is asking you to step out on some faith and really walk into some boldness for this next season, because there's been a lot of tension with someone who's been very upset. I feel like this is definitely a very angry energy. Queen of Swords in reverse can have a really sharp tongue and can be very, you know, bitter and judgmental. And I feel like, you know, if you're dealing with someone like this, it's because you've broken their heart. You left them feeling like there wasn't any love left for them, even though there is love left for them. So Scorpio, if you've been out here breaking hearts, you know, you need to get to the end of that type of behavior. I feel like you're really just working against yourself here and causing your own tower moments and losing stability in all of your relationships, okay? So if you have Scorpio in your chart, you need to tighten up, because you're really just pissing people off and you're really not caring about anything. All right, so here we go. We've got the, what else do we need? Aquarius, Four of Coins reversed. So you've had a recent breakup, Aquarius, with someone that you were with for a long time, Six of Cups. You were with them for quite some time, and I feel like there was, you know, an imbalance in the relationship. Let's see what else we have. What else do we have for Aquarius, Spirit? Okay, yeah. So Spirit was saying that this is something where you were both putting in a lot of effort. But, you know, there was some love lost here with the female energy. There was a lot of disappointment in reasons for feeling guarded and emotional. And I feel like this situation was just very, very much of a burden for both of you. So we have here the Four of Cups again. So this is an energy I've been seeing a whole lot, where people are just feeling heartbroken in this season. A lot of broken dreams are happening at this time, where people are getting out of stagnant relationships. They've been stuck here. And it's really requiring them to pull up strength to get out of their comfort zone for routines. You know, you can be with someone for a long time and just get stuck with them, thinking like things will get better. But really, maybe you're just comfortable with them and that's what you tell yourself so that you can stay. But there's gonna be a lot of communication for you with that bitter person that you have ended your relationship with. I think that they're pretty tired of working on everything as well, and you both should come to some type of mutual agreement. Okay, let me see, what else do we have? I'm trying to think of what other. All right, what am I forgetting now? I don't know. Did I forget your sign, guys? I probably did because I didn't write them all down. I don't think that was 12. Let me shuffle for a minute, see if I can think of anything. Oh, the Leos. Let's do Leos. All right, Leos, what do we got? Leos, you've been working really hard. And I feel like you have been putting in most of the effort and not so much your partner, and you're pretty sick of having to be the one to, you know, raise the vibration of the relationship and keep things balanced and stable on the home front. So, yeah, at this time, I feel like, again, there's a four of Wands in reverse, the breakup situation. I feel like someone has made up their mind who their person is and what they want to do with them. So, Leo, if you know who your star is, go towards that person and do it unapologetically. Love conquers all. And I feel like, you know, you want to go towards this person because you're remorseful, but they're very guarded because maybe you've hurt them too much, okay? And I feel like this person used to be loving and nurturing to you, but now it's like, for you, absolutely not. I feel like for other people, yes, and for you, no. think that maybe, you know, once you've burnt a bridge so much, sometimes it could be hard for that person to let you back in. So let me go ahead and go with the ancestor cards here. Did I forget your sign? Let me know. Oh, you know what? I forgot the Libra. Let me do Libra. My bad, Libra. Libra, Libra. What do we have for Libra, Spirit? Libra, I feel like you are taking a break from someone who is very narcissistic and emotionally abusive. Libra, we've got a heavy sense here of emotional abuse and you wanting some justice for this. And it's like you don't want to walk away from this person, but they've left you as an option for too long and you've got no other choice. Let me do Sagittarius next. Sagittarius, what do we have? Sash. Yeah, at this time, I feel like in the past, recent past, you had someone who broke your heart, but you're moving on from this now. Sagittarius. Yeah, I feel like that person that broke your heart made way more bad memories than any good, and you've decided to leave them behind. Your intuition told you all of these things and you didn't want to believe it, but now you see that karma is here and regardless of what you've chosen, things are playing out as they should. All right, so it seems like the person that you're dealing with wasn't very happy that you did this and they were pretty evil at the end of all of this. And really, I think that they were just trying to release all of their pain upon you so that they didn't have to feel it. Or everything they felt on the inside, they tried to take it out on you. So I'm sorry about that, Libra. Okay. What else do we have? It feels like there is a really attractive woman that you're going to be starting a relationship with, that you're going to need to be very careful on how you deal with this person, because it may seem like they're all good up front, but it looks like they're very toxic. So be careful with that. All right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up and post it up for you. This was my pre-weekend quickie for all signs, and I hope y'all liked it. If you have other placements in your chart, listen to all of them, not just the ones that's your sun sign, okay? So you can check out CoStar, CoStar, STAR.com. Download your birth chart there. All right, guys. Thanks so much. Love y'all. I'm out.